Hello friends, today we will study the topics types of media part 2. Let me introduce you the introduction part. Selection of right media is very important for achieving the objectives of advertising. An advertising media is a means or vehicle of delivering a definite message. It is a means through which an advertising message or information is passed on to the prospective customers, readers, viewers, listeners or passers-by. For instance, a producer seeks through advertisement media to keep in touch with old customers as well as to attract the new customers. Media are subject to intensive buying and selling activity. Examples of media are newspapers, magazines, radio, television, direct mail, posters, film, and catalogs, etc. After completion of this session, you will be able to understand press advertising, merits and demerits of newspaper advertising, magazine and journal advertising, advantages and disadvantages, film advertising, advantages and disadvantages, outdoor or mural advertising, types of outdoor advertising, merits and demerits. Friends, let's understand what is press advertising. Meaning of press advertising. Press advertising is the most popular and effective method of publicity today. It has become the part of culture and political life of people today. Press, also referred to as print, is an advertising media comprising all those vehicles owned by others and which can carry the advertising message in print to be read by target customers. In India, this media is commonly used by companies and account for nearly 70% of their total expenditure on advertising media. Forms or types. Press advertising takes two major forms. One is newspapers. Newspapers are bought largely for their news values. Newspapers may be national, local, daily or weekly. These are a good vehicle to pass on information about new products, current products or price of deals. They can be used for local, national and regional market coverage. In India, there are a number of newspapers both in English and also in regional languages. Many newspapers in English and Hindi have nationwide coverage. So, a message given in newspapers may have a better impression on the minds of the people. And it may be more specific, clear, complex and lengthy. Currently, 1173 daily newspapers and 5280 weekly newspapers are published in India, out of which the largest number is accounted for by the Hindi language newspapers, followed by Urdu, Marathi and English newspapers. In terms of number, and English, Hindi, Malayalam, Marathi and Gujarati in terms of circulation. Among the states, largest number of newspapers are published in Uttar Pradesh, followed by Maharashtra and Karnataka. Among the prominent national English language dailies are the Times of India, Hindustan, Indian Express, Statesman and Economics Times, etc. Whereas among the national Hindi language dailies, it includes Hindustan Times, Nav Bharat Times, National Duniya and Rajasthan Patrika. However, among the different language groups, companies in India, both in state and private sector, largely use English dailies as their advertising media. Small enterprises prefer local newspapers as their advertising media. The newspapers charge on the basis of column centimeter space used by the advertiser. They also charge premium for special positions, provide concession for space booking on contract. However, these rates vary from newspaper to newspaper as per their circulation and coverage. Friends, now let's understand the advantages of newspaper advertising media. The advantages of newspaper advertising media may be summed up as their coverage is high as they reach every nook and corner in a very short time. They offer a lot of flexibility according to the convenience and necessity of the advertiser. The shape, size, appeal may be frequently changed to suit the need of the advertiser. High frequency enables speedy preparation and publication of the advertisement. It is the cheapest media of advertising as far as its cost per reader is concerned. The daily newspaper have strong repetitive value as it offers an opportunity to the advertiser to repeat its message at a short interval of only one day. The public response towards newspaper advertising is very quick. By inserting local advertisements in local newspapers, the effectiveness of advertising copy could be tested quite easily. By inserting frequent advertisements in the newspapers, their visual appeals may be created very easily. The reputation of newspaper and their products is available to the advertisers. Leading newspapers provide space to reputed and reliable concerns only. Newspaper advertising provides geographic selectivity. The disadvantages or demerits or limitations of newspaper advertising media are: the life of newspaper is very short, that is only for the day. It is said, nothing is alive as today's newspaper and nothing is dead as yesterday's newspaper. There is waste of circulation. The advertisement is carried even to those places where there is no market existing nor the possibility of creating a new market in the near future. If the customers are limited in numbers, advertising in newspapers may be ineffective and costly too. Visual effects may not be created in practice as the newspapers are generally printed on cheap newsprint. There is lack of uniformity in advertisers' and publishers' requirements with respect to rates, size, type of copy and so on. Newspaper advertising is less popular in undeveloped countries where the masses are illiterate, ignorant and poor. Magazines and journals. Another media under press advertising media is magazines and journals. They offer selective circulation throughout the country at a cost within reasonable budget limits. These are published periodically at a regular intervals, that is weekly, fortnightly, monthly, quarterly or annually. Magazines and journals are read at leisure and with care when the reader is mentally prepared to receive the advertisements. It has a long effective life. From the advertiser's point of view, magazines may be classified under five groups: special interest magazines, trade magazines, technical magazines, professional magazines and regional magazines. Advantages or merits of magazines and journals. The advantages of magazines and journals as an advertising media are: the life of magazine is considerably longer than the newspapers. These are read for weeks and months. Better reproduction of advertisement than newspapers is provided. Magazines are highly selective in nature and waste of circulation is avoided. Magazine advertising creates prestige, reputation and an image of quality. The number of readers per copy in case of magazine advertising is quite high. There is a multiplicity of readership. Magazines are ideal for introducing new idea. Magazine readership is usually a leisurely home readership for enjoyment and relaxation. The printing paper color combination is more attractive in case of magazine advertising than newspaper advertising. Magazines reach specialized groups conveniently and effectively. The cost of utilizing magazines for advertising is quite low. Now friends, let's understand the disadvantages of magazine and journal advertising. As compared to newspaper advertising, the magazine and journal advertising disadvantages are: the chief demerit of magazine advertising is its low flexibility. Preparation cost for magazine copy are usually high and sometimes exceeds the cost of space used in trade magazines. The circulation is limited as compared to newspaper advertising. It takes more time in printing etc. than the newspaper advertising. The size of magazines differs widely, and hence the advertiser has to prepare the copy of advertisement according to the size of magazine and journal. Change in appeal cannot be effective quickly. The next topic is film advertising. Let us understand the meaning of film advertising. Film is an audiovisual medium of communication and offers wide opportunities to the advertiser to screen commercial films and slides produced by them. Today, cinema is an important and effective media of advertising. Suitable short films may be prepared to create a lasting impression upon the audience. This may be presented in the form of a story or a cartoon. Though the merits of the product are presented to the audience effectively, such films may be shown before the start of the feature film or during the interval. At present, there are three kinds of films used as media of advertising. Friends, there are different kinds of films. The first is straight advertising films. These are most common nowadays. These concentrate on advertising message relating to only one product of a particular company, such as Hindustan Lever, Tata Oil Mills, Toilet Preparations, DCM, Gwalior Rayon, Calico, etc. These are short duration lasting for 3 to 5 minutes. The next is documentary films. Documentary films are mainly used for publicity aspect and in most cases is educative in character. They are used to show various aspects of an industry as a whole. The next is sponsored advertising films. It is a very good combination of advertisement and entertainment. Cartoon films come under this category. In India, cinema has practically reached in all the parts of the country. Mumbai has become the hub of the advertising films and slides production. With all this, cinema as an advertising media holds great opportunities, particularly for those companies which are poised to penetrate the rural market of our country. It is particularly relevant for advertising consumer products and farm inputs. Friends, now let's understand the advantages of film advertising. The first is that it has a quite wide coverage. It is able to explain and demonstrate the use of a product quite conveniently. Appeal is made to all sections of the society. It is never wasted, as no advertisement can escape the attention. It is effective and may pay rich dividend to the advertiser. Now, let's understand disadvantages. The first is films are too short and need changes frequently. Production cost of a film is quite high. The audience may not like to waste time in seeing such films repeatedly. They resent to it, as they come for entertainment only. Restrictions are imposed against screening of films. For example, there is censoring. For screening films, the cooperation of theaters is a must, which is not easily available. Friends, the next topic is purchase point advertising. Purchase point advertising is that advertising which is undertaken at the premises of the manufacturer or the dealer for attracting the customers. This is a direct method because the advertising process is either undertaken by the manufacturer directly or through the dealer. Under this method, goods are displayed at the counters, windows, or in almirahs. It is observed that the point of purchase is the exact point where the prospects are reminded finally about a product. It is considered as a powerful media nowadays. Friends, let's understand what is specialty advertising. In this media of advertising, manufacturers provide various articles of low value free of cost to the existing and prospective customers. The article constitutes calendars, ball pens, diaries, cigarette cases, bags, and other executive gifts. Such articles bear the name and address of the advertiser. it is felt that recipients will do business with the firm in the near future even though the articles are given on no obligation basis. It is also called novelty advertising. These articles are given to targeted customers. Friends, now let's understand what is video advertising. It is now considered as the latest media of advertising. Under this method, CDs and DVD ad films are prepared. Nearly 22 million people around the world watch Indian films on video. India alone has video audience of about 30 million, which is increasing day by day. There are more than 50,000 video libraries and about 1 lakh video parlors clubs in India. CDs and DVDs released in India are also being screened in thousands of luxury buses. Besides the feature film, they contain advertisements which are displayed at short intervals. Friends, what is outdoor or mural advertising? Let us understand the meaning of outdoor or mural advertising. Outdoor or mural advertising is the oldest form of advertising and remains the most common media even today. It is also called wall advertising. Outdoor advertising consists of display of advertisements out of door, which may be in the form of posters, painted signs, field signs, neon light signs, hoardings and posters carried by sandwich man. This is also referred to as mural advertising, as posters consisting of a picture are often placed on walls, particularly a large one, printed directly on a wall, or large photographs attached directly to a wall. Small placards or posters placed outside or inside carriages such as trams, delivery vans, buses, railway carriages, etc. also come under this category. The new form of advertising by using balloons, kites and smoke writing in the sky is also a part of outdoor advertising. Outdoor advertising is not always argumentative but suggestive. The effectiveness of such advertising material depends on its positions. Therefore, outdoor advertisements must be placed in such a way as can be seen by a large number of prospective customers with ample attention. The articles suited for such advertising are those which the masses can buy, such as food products, soaps, medicines, cigarettes, shoes, clothes and other domestic requirements. Friends, let us understand the main characteristics of outdoor advertisement. It is a widespread popular advertising media which makes the goods and services of interest to mass appeal. It has a comparatively longer life. It has a high coverage. The most outdoor advertisements are big and dominant. So, it is a very powerful eye-catching media. It is a very flexible advertising media so that the advertiser can retain sites where he needs them most. It is the oldest advertising media. It also consists of suitable and popular slogans which can be easily remembered by the prospects. Friends, now let's understand what are the types, forms or kinds of outdoor advertising. The first is posters. Friends, this is the most common and popular form of outdoor advertising. These are exhibited on a hoarding or on walls, roofs, fences, chimneys, etc. A really commanding effect can be produced by posters which cost less than any other advertising media. Design is the basis of all poster advertising. This mostly contains pictures. Advertising for a movie is done in this way. Even when no pictures are used, the proper arrangement of lettering is important. The poster should be simple, attractive, and capable of telling its story at a glance. Posters also give considerable scope for the use of suitable and attractive colors. Humor can also be used with advantage in poster advertising. The next is advertising board. Friends, advertising board are also posters which are kept at certain fixed places, especially at points where people frequently assemble, such as bus stops, railways, crossings, etc. Generally, these advertising boards are made of metallic sheet, enclosed in a wooden frame and fixed with a panel having specified height at main junctions. These are fixed and well set with floodlights. The next is vehicle advertising. It refers to moving advertisement. It consists of placing posters or placards inside or outside the vehicles, such as trams, buses, taxis, delivery vans, railway carriages, etc. The main advantage of this system is the small space available for such posters. These posters are fairly sighted by the eyes and can be easily read. This method is a very common media and is considered to be very effective. The next is electric displays and signs. Signs illuminated by electricity are today to be seen in large numbers in cities. This is the most modern and the most attractive form of outdoor display. It may consist of wooden letters studded with bulbs. Sometimes, with a view to attract the attention, colored bulbs are also used and the colors are changed at short intervals. Another device used to attract attention is to turn on the light on each letter at a time to give the impression of the sign being written by an invisible hand. Friends, what is neon signs? Neon signs are brilliantly colored tubes available in various shades. This can be of the steel or the flashing type. These signs are more attractive and interesting than the signs built up by a number of electric bulbs. Now, let's understand what is sky advertising. Sky advertising is also known as sky writing. Sky advertising is another modern form of outdoor advertising. In this form of advertising media, an aeroplane writes the name of the product or the producer in the sky. It is also known as smoke writing because the message is written in the sky by means of smoke. Large sized printed balloons are also dropped from the aeroplane in the sky. Usually, near the circus stands, a large sized balloon is floated on which the name of the circus is written. The next is sandwichmen. Friends, they are hired people and properly dressed who walk in the streets in a procession with boards, posters and notices placed about them. The cinema theaters usually arrange these kinds of advertising media when a new picture is released. The next is stickers. It is also an important form of outdoor advertising. In this case, the advertiser enters in a contract with the popular players that whatever they will wear or use during the match will bear the sticker of the advertiser. Friends, now let's understand what is puppet shows. This is purely an Indian outdoor advertising media which is provided entertainment while conveying a message. Nowadays, it is used widely in the family planning campaign in India, mostly in villages. One such show tells how a rich man of the village who has large family rejects the family planning campaign, but his wife has twins and there are complications. He calls in the midwife who tells him that his wife will not survive more births. He accepts the family planning advice and so becomes the innovator in this village. However, there may be other forms of this type of advertising. Now, let's understand the advantages of outdoor advertising media. First is, it has a wide coverage. It is capable of gaining more attention of the public. Outdoor advertising is more useful for local dealers. Its results can be more readily secured by using this form of advertising. In big cities and high traffic areas, outdoor advertising is the most effective form of advertising. outdoor advertising is more flexible. It offers greater selectivity because it can be used locally, regionally, or even nationally. It can be easily remembered. It is quite economical. It has comparatively long life. It is a very good media to stress brand names and package identity. Let's understand the disadvantages of outdoor advertising media. The outdoor advertising media possess disadvantages, demerits, or limitations, and thus is subject to criticism. It is subject to adverse reaction of the public on the ground that the walls of the houses are used for writing. Outdoor advertisement even without the permission of the owner of the house. The message written under this type of advertising is too brief. The exact effect created on prospects is difficult to measure. The language used in writing on the wall advertising is usually defective and sometimes immoral too. It has an adverse effect on the public. Now, let's understand emerging media options. Let's understand the meaning of emerging media options. There are several media options which have emerged due to increased popularity of advertising. Advertising through cell phones and marketing through social sites are some of the emerging media options. Alternative media options. We shall discuss the alternative media options like car cards. Car cards are small size thick papers and posters placed inside the vehicles like the buses or railway trains. They are also posted on the window screens or the side glasses of the motor cars. The main purpose is to remind the travelers about the product. However, it is possible that many travelers may not look at the cards while traveling. Traveling displays. These car cards are posted outside the vehicles or local trains. The purpose is to attract the attention outside public or of those who are standing on railway platforms. Sandwich boards or tall man advertising. Sandwich boards advertisement is carried by a man with two posters hung on his two sides. The man is known as a sandwich man as he is sandwiched between two boards. He moves from one street to another and attracts the attention of the passerby. To add the unusual sight, sometimes a tall man carrying the boards walks with the supports of long sticks and with funny mask and clothes and attracts the passerby. The next is skywriting or sky balloons. In this type, a painted balloon or a plastic sheet having advertisement message may be attached to the tail of the flying aeroplane. This being very unusual thing, people are attracted towards it. Advantages. It acts as a supporting or supplementary to press media effectively. It is constantly reminding prospects of the products. It is colorful and has a pleasing appearance. So, prospects welcome this form of publicity. It has a wide appeal. It attracts all human population of literates and illiterates. This media is more permanent compared to newspapers, films, magazines, etc. It provides scope for talents, skill, and art. Disadvantages. It is difficult in measuring the response as it appeals to the general public and not in particular. Selection of wrong site, wrong materials, wrong method, etc. wastage may arise. Also, due to damages to the posters, hoarding, etc., wastages are created. This media can be used only as a supporting media to the others like TV, radio, etc. It is alleged that posters, hoardings, neon signs, etc. spoil the natural beauty of the places. Display or indoor publicity. To display goods means to show the goods to the people in order to induce them to enter the shop and buy them. It is a device by which customers and people are attracted to the shop. The importance of display. It is only as a part of the publicity which allows people to touch the products, to handle them, or to actually see them. It is more realistic in salesmanship. Another importance of display is that display is an important dealer aid. The display technique helps the dealers to conduct an effective publicity. The third important factor that has given importance to display is that it attracts the attention of the prospects and makes the people walk into the shops. Lastly, display is important to its effect not only on prospects but also on the suspects. It makes the message directly to the prospects through their eyes. There are different forms of displays. The first is window display. It refers to showing of goods in the window of the shop. Window of a shop means a part of the front portion of the shop which can be seen from outside. Windows are meant for outsiders to peep in. Window display technique is used by retailers or small businessmen because they cannot afford to spend on other media. Window display is used for all type of consumer goods. It makes people eager to know and see the products. Friends, here are the rules for the shopkeepers while displaying the goods in windows. Normally, the windows of a rectangular shapes are selected and not the vertical one because they provide for adequate space and easy movement of vision. The item should be arranged horizontally and not vertically because this allows easy gaze movement. The background of window should be attractive and pleasant. The window should not be overcrowded with items because it strains the eyes of the viewers. The position of the items displayed should be changed from time to time to create variety. Proper lighting and illumination of the window should be done so that they focus on the special features of the product. The display technique should not violate the basic rules of decent approach. There should not be overcrowding of expensive good in too fashionable setting, otherwise the prospects would be frightened and the result would go negative. The next is interior decoration. It refers to the various designs and equipments used by a retailer inside his shop. Showcases, counters, lighting arrangement, ventilation, etc. It creates a pleasant atmosphere for the prospects and increases their comforts. Effective interior decoration does not require a lot of space, but it makes appropriate use of the available space to provide for easy movement and get up. The next is counter display. It refers to arranging the products located within the shop. Counter display helps the customers to know about all the items which are available in the shop. Such a facility is not available in window display because all the items cannot be presented in the window. A good salesman must see that he should not show any goods which may go against the window display. Secondly, counter display must bring out as many varieties as are related to the particular type displayed at the window. Thirdly, the salesman must see that goods are not placed one upon the other. The next is showcases. In this type, the items are presented in a cupboard with glass front of cabinets with glass front. These are similar to window display in the sense that showcases should be rectangular, items should be placed horizontally. In showcases, items of similar nature and size should be grouped together so that the customer knows the varieties of the same type available. The showcases should contain all the items available in the shops. The next is showrooms. Showroom is used by many producers or dealers not only to expose goods for sale but also demonstrate the uses and the working of the articles. It is meant for presentation of technical products, sophisticated goods, etc., which require lot of explanation before buying the products. Showrooms have technically qualified persons to assist the customers when they visit the showrooms and also advise and guide them to understand the goods better. The next is exhibitions. The trade exhibitions are meant for introducing new products or latest innovations in the fields of business. They are organized by trade associations of Chamber of Commerce. The main idea behind exhibitions is that various traders, manufacturers, etc. can be induced to visit and get information about the products displayed. In exhibition, there is only presentation of the products and no sale takes place. For this purpose, the stalls are decorated and the items are presented in an attractive manner. Exhibitions have mass approach because many people visit them. The next is trade fairs. Trade fair is similar to exhibition, except that in the trade fair, not only the items are exhibited, but are also sold. Besides, entertainment items are staged to attract hundreds of people. Thus, there is business and fun in the trade fairs. Now, friends, let's summarize. Selection of right media is important for achieving the objectives of advertising. Selection of right type of advertising media depends on the factors like the nature of production, market requirement, advertising objectives, distribution strategy, budget, competitors' choice, media availability, etc. There are a number of advertising media choices available in India like radio, FM radio broadcasting, internet, television, press, magazine and journals, mural advertising, etc. But not any single media can satisfy all the objectives of the company. In this session, we discussed the further types of media, which included press advertising, merits and demerits of newspaper advertising, magazine and journal advertising, advantages and disadvantages, and lastly, outdoor or mural advertising, types of outdoor advertising, merits and demerits. Thank you for listening to me, and I hope it would have helped you in understanding advertising better.